What's up, guys? It's P-Team, and I got the MX Garand from a rare supply drop, so let's talk about it a little bit today, and let's talk about, you know, a lot of people think the gun is unfair, you know, that it's behind supply drops and, you know, what people would consider paid supply drops and stuff, so let's talk about that a little bit. So first of all, the MX Garand, it's pretty good. It shoots like 15% faster than the Shiva, but the problem is that it has severe ammo issues. So it only has 8 bullets without extended mags, and it has 12 bullets with extended mags. And the more bigger problem is that you cannot reload. So like right now I have 4 bullets in my, you know, MX, and I cannot reload it until I shoot them all. I have to physically shoot out all the bullets to zero for it to reload. So the other issue is that, well, first of all, that's a major, major issue. I mean, when you're down to like, you know, 2, 3, 4 bullets, it's like, do you shoot them out and reload? You know, and if you do, you know, it takes time to do that. And then you're also giving yourself away on the mini map. You know, so there's a lot of different issues with that. Secondly, it has recoil too. So like the Shiva, the Shiva doesn't need grip, first of all. If you ever see somebody running a Shiva with a grip, they just don't know what they're doing. You can literally shoot the Shiva the whole clip, and it literally every bullet hits in the same spot. The MX Garand is not like that. It bounces all over the place. Like if you're aiming at somebody's head, it just misses sometimes. It does not shoot exactly where you want it. So it has recoil issues. So personally, I don't think it's better than the Shiva, and I actually have a higher KD with the Shiva. I don't use the Shiva anymore, really. I become a lot more of a rusher, except for on Nuketown. You know, I like to play on Nuketown differently than I play in other spaces. You know, a lot of DOMs I flank and stuff. But I actually have a better KD with the Shiva, and I actually think the Shiva is better because the only advantage to the MX Garand is it shoots 15% faster. But the ammo issue, you cannot overcome it. It's not as much. It's just much harder, and they actually nerfed the Garand here. It used to have a better range reduction with the suppressor, and they got rid of that now. So now it has the same range reduction. It's like 60 or 70%. It reduces your range. So it's actually not good with the suppressor anymore. So the only advantage is it shoots a little bit faster, but with the recoil and the ammo issues, you know, the Shiva's better. So, you know, I wouldn't go and spend money on the game trying to get the MX Garand. You know, if you get it from a supply drop, use it and stuff. You know, it's fun to get a new gun, fun to play around with a little bit. You know, but don't be mad at yourself if you don't get it. Don't think it's an overpowered gun or it's the greatest gun, you know, ever. It's just something interesting to use. It's kind of like the Shadow Claw. You know, it's something interesting, but it's not a big deal if you don't get it. I mean, you'll see me in this video a lot of times. I have a couple bullets left, and I literally have to just shoot them out to get rid of them, just to reload. You know, so if you consider that into the reload time is actually horrendous. It takes several seconds because, you know, you have to shoot your ammo out to get rid of it and stuff. So, you know, also the MX Garand being a single shooter, it's not really a run-and-gun type of gun. You'll see here, I'm 25 points from a mothership here. So it's too hard to run-and-gun with MX Garand. You have to be posted up, which, you know, a lot of people would consider a camping gun and stuff. So look here, I got my mothership, and I'm going to jump in. So let's talk about the mothership a lot. I like the mothership a lot. My average kills per use is over 10. And compared to like Raps and GI unit, my kills per use are only like 4. So although it costs like 1700 points, it's really worth it because you get so many kills. So, you know, certain maps are better. You know, Nuketown's a really good map for a mothership because of the fact that most of it's outdoors. And the person who got the mothership has a much better gunner than the support gunner. So first of all, the main turret never overheats, and the support gunner turrets overheat. You literally can only shoot them for like 5 seconds, and then they overheat. You also get mothership assist points for assist kills, and you got the rockets. You know, the rockets, you know, definitely give off a lot of damage, and you can shoot them like it seems like every 5 seconds. They regenerate and stuff. And look at all these kills I'm getting with the mothership. You know, it's not uncommon for you to get 15 or 20 kills from the mothership. You just can't do that with wraps. You know, they only drop like, and my time actually run out there, I'm 40-0 in the first half. But, you know, on the other hand, I don't recommend mothership if you can't get high streaks like that. You know, when I'm running and gunning and I'm flanking and, you know, I'm going aggressive, I don't run mothership. You know what I'm saying? Because even if you go on a 10 streak or a 15 streak, you're probably not even going to get your mothership there because, you know, it costs 1,700 points. So just keep that in mind. You know, you got to play passive, you got to play more cautious, but you still got to be able to get streaks like that. You know, these counter UAVs and UAVs are great because they're, you know, they're a good 100 to 200 free points like that. But the MX Garand is really good with extended mags. Fast mags helps just a little bit. You know, I definitely think it needs extended mags because it gives you 12 bullets before you have to reload. High caliber is good. It gives you those one-shot headshots, but it's only shotgun range. If you add in long barrel, it doubles the one-shot range for the headshot. And so the range is pretty much, like, if you're in the window at Newtown, the high caliber range goes to, like, between the buses. That's the high caliber range. It's kind of like an Argus shotgun range. If you add long barrel and high caliber, it can one-shot from window to window, only if both guys are standing near the front of the window. So it doubles the range. It's good. You know, if they're in the back of the window, you're not going to be able to one-shot headshot them. But, you know, I question sometimes if, like, high caliber and long barrel are worth it. You don't really need long barrel besides those headshots because the range on the two-shot, it's like 2,000 in-game units. I know that's hard to, like, think about, but it's a very, very long range if you're not running suppressor. So I don't really think long barrel is needed. You're rarely going to even have a three-shot kill range that you can see somebody at. Long barrel is only paired with high caliber for those extra long headshots, but that makes you question, it's like, are those two attachments worth it? You know, just for headshots. You know, it depends on how many you know, if you're only getting a couple headshots a game, was it really worth it? Would you have killed them anyways just with one more bullet? You know, and really, if you headshot them on the second bullet, they were going to die anyway, so the headshot didn't even matter. So just keep that in mind. You know, it's fun to get those one-shot headshots, but, you know, it takes up a lot of attachments to do it. So definitely extended mags. You know, you could run it just with extended mags and a sight if you wanted, because it's a precision shooter. You know, grips helps a little bit because it does bounce around, but it's, you know, it's not super noticeable. Just like, I don't run grip on a lot of guns nowadays because, you know, it's a very minimal noticement. So that lets you, you know, add on perks. It just depends on how many attachments you want to run. But suppressor is no longer really good on the MX Garand because it reduces your range by like 70%. So just keep that in mind. So here I go. I'm getting close to... Okay, so here, look, here's... So this mothership actually was by my buddy Swift. Got a second mothership here in this game. I got the first one. And so here you're going to see the support gunner. I'm 60-0 right now at this point. So you're going to see the support gunner. So look, I can't see the map. I'm turning left, I'm turning right, and I can't see the map. So, you know, that's the problem with support gunner. So I actually had to move position here. And look, I still can't see the map. So now I'm finally getting around to seeing the map, kind of. And by the way, you can switch to thermal vision. And look, I can't see the map again. So I literally got zero kills out of the support gunner that time. You know, a lot of people complain about the support gunner like it's, you know, stealing their kills. But it's, you know, it's not really. And really, it's helping out your team a lot. You know, when you get a mothership, the other team is crushed. Completely handicapped. So here we go. I'm 200 points from my second mothership. And now I'm 120 points. So here we go. I'm gonna put a little cautious here, try to get this, you know, last 120 points. They're throwing grenades at me and shit. So now I'm 20 points from my last mothership. 20 points. Oh! And that is how you die. 20 points from a second mothership in a game. So I don't really play with the MX Garand anymore. In my opinion, the Shiva's better. So, you know, don't be all mad if you don't got it and stuff. you know, if you get it, pick it up and use it, or if you get it, you know, use it. It's kind of fun to use for a little bit, but like right there, I had to reload. If I didn't kill that guy, I would have totally been dead. I wouldn't have had a shot at all. So Sixth Sense is very useful if you're going to be in the Nuketown houses. You know, awareness isn't really useful on Nuketown because there's just so much shooting and crazy stuff going on. It's hard to really hear everything. So there you go, guys. Double mothership. Me and my buddy got one, and I'm 20 points off my second mothership. MX Garand. It's not the greatest gun in the world, so don't worry about it. And that's it, guys. 67-2 that game. I will catch you next time. See ya.